Hello everyone. Today I am going to discuss the chapter implements and tools used in logging operations. And there are variety of or very wide range of implements. Those are used for different purposes, since cleaning of the ground till the conversion of the felled trees, or the tools are divided as per the traditional and then new improvised or mechanized tools also. But here we will start with the traditional tools, and it is initiated by the X. Number one of them is X, or it is being considered as traditional tool, or in India X's are used for various purposes actually, or these are felling, trimming, splitting and then grubbing, means we have to remove the bark, etc. So these four functions of the axes are also the type of axe accordingly. So for these all functions or actions, there are different kind of axes also. The felling axe are quite variable, both in size and their shape, and each type has some advantages also over the others. For each of the above purpose, different kind of axe would be used, and felling axes can be used for all the purposes. Any of these can be used for any purpose if not available with the other type of axe. Any of the axe has two major parts. The one is metal head, and another second part is wooden handle. The axe head carries a socket that is called eye, into which the handle fitted. The portion of head in front of the eye is known as blade, and that on the either side and behind the eye is known as back of the axe. This is the description of axe. Now we will discuss the axe head. What are its different specifications actually? What could be its weight? These are mentioned herein. I will come one by one. The axe head consists of the cutting edge and body with eye or hole in it. The best type of axe head is either solid piece of iron with a steel base welded into it, or the two tapering pieces of iron between which a narrow wedge of steel is inserted. This projects slightly beyond the two pieces of from the edge. The edge is carefully tempered and tested for toughness and strength also. It should be sharp and of proper temper, neither too soft, in which case it would bend, nor too brittle also. Using to the chip, the side of the blade should slightly be convex and proportioned to enter the wood easily. Here we have some specification of the blade. And the edge of blade should be slightly curved, as the this will produce the better penetration and renders the corners less liable to break off. The weight of head varies with the type of timber to be cut and work to be done. Generally, axe head weigh from 1.5 kg to 2 kg or sometime more. If we are going for heavier tree, larger tree, then it will need more heavy axe head. The heavier type reaches up to 2.5 kg also, and generally used for larger tree as I have mentioned herein. Okay, broad axes are sometimes used for such tasks as squaring of logs, when the workman stand on the log and the weight of falling axe do most of the work. They have edges 25 to 30 cm or sometime more in width, with heads weighing 2.5 kg and long handles. Correct grinding, I think it should be gripping of the axe to sharpen them, is of great importance, because the ease and efficiency in use and the length of life in service are generally increased thereby. So these are the specification of axe head. Now we comes to axe handle, or here are the specifications of the axe handle. Standard length of the axe handle is about 90 cm, but length varying from 70 to 120 cm, as on the basis of size of tree or nature of species also. In our country, round handles fitting in round eyes are almost used. Round handles are easily made and should be available cheaply also. These can be, if the handle could be break by chance, it can be easily replaced on the spot by cutting a solid bamboo or a straight piece of tough wood from the adjacent trees. The greatest disadvantage is that they are liable to slide around the eye by when the use is over. I mean to say that the older handles are quite slipped around that eye. The round shape also does not fit the natural space in the hand. European and American axes in contrast have oval shaped handles and eyes. In this case, the handle cannot slip around the eye and adds the power to the worker. The grip of handle and improve the balance of the whole axe when it swung. The chief disadvantage of such handles is that they cannot be replaced easily unless spares are kept in the stock. Then we move to next implement, or this is bill hook, a very simple common tool generally found in every household, and for such purposes it is used for clearing the bushes or hedges, or sometime lopping for fodder, or cutting the small branches. The here in this logging operation, it is also used for same, to clearing the ground beneath any tree that is to be intended for felling, or it is a tool often used for felling the bamboos, the small poles, and for clearing the and chopping of bushes growth underneath the trees. They exhibit a great variety of shapes, and each time being preferred in the locality where it is used. Here I would like to draw the bill hook around here only. Suppose this is handle. Oh, it is quite disturbing. What I could find here, so this is handle, okay. Then we have this. Okay, this is one kind of bill hook. These are some chain like things after this handle. This is wooden handle, this is iron blade, or quite this is general shape of any this bill hook actually. Or here we have this chain also, or this is if anybody would like to ask what is the purpose of this chain herein, then one can answer that the purpose of this chain is to just awaken the animals. Those are in hibernation near the tree, those are intended for felling, and under the bushes sometimes they are there, like snakes and scorpions or various other type of animals. Those could attack to the workers. So for this purpose it will with the working it will definitely have some sound, and the mentioned animals could get away from that place, and it will be easy for workers to do their work. So this is the purpose of this chain, and that is quite fitted around the handle, wooden handle. Now the next part, that is saw, or normally hand saws are the mostly used felling tools. I use for felling and conversion also, and they are cheap, always ready for the use, simple to handle and easy to maintain also. Power chain saws are expensive in the procurement for maintenance as well as working also. The working is most more difficult, but speed of output is more much more with these power chain saws. Saws are used for felling, cross cutting and ripping the logs into scantlings, sleepers and various other classes of converted material. Saws are called two or one man saw according to whether they are worked by two or one man. Only two man saw can be used for felling in the logging operation, except in case of small trees and poles. Or generally carpenters, small scale carpenters are used one man saw, as you have noticed in the carpentry shops. Then there are several part of a very simple cross cut saw, and these are mentioned here, and the one of them is face. As you have noticed or think about the saw blade, the face is the edge of the tooth which faces the cutting direction, and this is a symbol of that face. Then we have second part, that is back, the opposite edge of any tooth, that is like this. Here the sharpened sides are there, those are used for cutting the trees. Then we have space, third part of the, any cross cutting simple toothing saw, and the distance from tooth to tooth measured at points of two adjacent teeth like this. These are the teeth or their points actually, and this distance is known as space. Now we have fourth part, that is gullet, or the entire opening between two adjacent teeth is known by gullet. Then we have number next part, number fifth, this is pitch, or the angle that is found between the face of tooth and the line passing through the points of the teeth is known as like this. This angle is known as pitch. Here I would like to draw again how we can draw the pitch. Suppose this is simple tooth, or the line that is comes here in the center of any tooth, or ye aa gaya, this is angle of the tooth, line passing through the points of the teeth. This is known as pitch. Okay, next part we have set, or the extent to which the teeth are bent to either side of the plane of any blade is known as set, or this is the bending pattern of the tooth, or this is known as set. Now we have next number seventh, that is kerf, and kerf is the width of any saw cut. Here again I would like to draw, suppose this is stem, or if we are going to make one action of any saw or axe, then the first or second or likewise cuts are, suppose this is cut, okay, so this is width of any saw cut or axe cut, this is known as kerf, that is its width only, okay. Then we have next the gauge, last part of any saw, and this is the thickness of any saw blade, and these are all the 8 parts and quite asked in examinations, whether in internals, whether in external exams. So you can be prepared for these all, or have to remember these all names. These are 8 parts of saw, simple toothing saw. Then we have diversification of saws. These are crosscut saws. Normally saws are known by crosscut saws, or we have here the specification of crosscut saw, and these are generally used for felling of trees and conversion purposes into logs or various other forms. The length, breadth and thickness of any saw blade, as well as its make, form, are the characteristic to be taken into consideration. The number one of them is length, or what could be the length of saw blade. The length of any saw blade must suit the movement of arms and the diameter to be cut. The suitable stroke length for crosscut saw lies between 80 to 100 centimeter length of any saw blade. For fixing the handle and for protecting the hands, a length of 5 to 15 centimeter must be allowed on the corners on both the ends of the saw. Two main saw of lesser length do not consider productive in the terms of work. There are some standard length of crosscut saw for general requirement are, if the diameter of tree are like this, then here these are the length of saw blade. The 140 to 150 centimeter is designed for 30 centimeter diameter of tree. Then these are the other specifications. Then we have next its breadth of this saw blade. What could be the here I would like to draw actually one small picture of saw blade. This here the pictures are quite these were not up to the mark actually. Or here I am going to draw this. These are 2 points for fixing the handle. Or these are tooth, not made by me as per that marks. And this is breadth actually. This span is known as breadth. Or here I was talking about the length. This was length. Okay, length of saw. And this is breadth as mentioned here. So breadth of any crosscut saw would be either 85 millimeters, it means 8.5 centimeter broad along the whole length, or sometime 80 millimeter at both the ends, 80 here and then 85 and towards the center, and at the end, and 120 centimeter in the middle. It would be 12 centimeter in the middle and 80 at the both ends. So this is the specification of saw breadth. Then we have one line is again mentioned here, that is the broader blade with thinner back can reduce the friction and works smooth in the cut. Then we have thickness of blade, as mentioned in the parts also. The strength of saw blade is influenced most by the thickness of that blade. Too thin saw are difficult to guide sometime and control properly. On the other hand, saws having thick blades produce a broad kerf also and require a large amount of energy, but it will more productive for saws of 80 millimeter breadth and 165 centimeter length A thickness of about 1.82 millimeter has proved quite suitable and productive also. Then we have a tooth shape. The next specification of saw, crosscut saw, that is tooth shape, or the most commonly used or most important part is its tooth shape. Out of many forms, there are two kind of tooths can be differentiated. The one first type of tooth are used to cut off the fiber and to break off the fiber that has been cut. Then next one we have to carry away the fibers or sawdust out of the kerf. This is the main job of the tooth, or one of them is categorized as peg toothing saw or peg toothing. Peg toothing is very simple triangular isocels like structure of the tooth, and these all are similar to each other. The points and edges of the teeth used to cut and loosen the wood fiber. The flanks of these teeth pushes the sawdust forward through the groove. Sawdust from the wood requires more space, therefore teeth of the saws for cutting should be separated from each other through a space, as we have mentioned in the part of saw, so that the sawdust does not remain sticking and comes outside the groove. The peg toothing is the most common or simple toothing of crosscut saws. Next we have a second kind, that is racker toothing. Or in the racker toothing, three tasks are delivered between two different kind of teeth of quite different forms. The cutter teeth cut the fibers along the both side of the groove. Each group of cutter is followed by a racker tooth, which works like a chisel, break off the fiber and carries them out of the saw curve in the form of long narrow chip, which have already been loosened on the side of cutting teeth. Then we have one more part, that is tooth line, and tooth line of the saw shows a certain curvature which is suited to its operation with the arms. The tooth line curvature should be maintained through upkeep the saws. Those are operated with the grip or handle which are fitted to both end of the saw. The grip should be comfortable and quickly removable. The spindle grip have proved the best. Just by turning the grips can be fitted and removed quickly. Then we have next type of saw, that is known by bow saw, or it is categorized under one man saw category, and for it is generally used for felling of small trees and poles and bamboos also, and other small size products. One man saw is used, and it is important amongst one man saws. The oval section of tubing makes a comfortable grip. This is tubing actually for handling or working this type of saws. Bow saw can be used for felling, sawing, limbing and cleaning also, or its blade length could be 90.10 centimeter. It is also used for clearing work as well as for firewood. The bow saw may have tacker tooth saw blades or peg tooth. This is not tacker actually, this is racker, or it is typo mistake here. It may have racker or peg toothing saw pattern. Next we have pruning saw. This is again very simple saw, or it is used for cutting the branches on growing trees for the purpose of cleaning the stem to secure high quality knot free timber. Pruning is generally done. A pruning saw fastened to a long rod, and it is difficult to use. A special type of saw is used for purpose. It has a tube handle. Sometime here we can see it is wooden handle actually, which is attached to a pole. That blade has a hollow tooth line with reverse teeth cutting on the backward stroke. These are reverse toothing actually herein. This reduces the risk that the saw may jump off the cut and damage the bark of tree. Excuse me. Then next we have how to maintain the saws, it should be maintained and attended regularly during working or even after working also, and this in this way we can maintain the efficiency of the saws. If the upkeep is neglected, it will definitely decrease the output or increase the energy requirement, which causes the waste of time as well as money. It has been shown or noticed that by the adequate and careful maintenance, the cutting capacity of saw can be enormously increased, or it can also save the time and money also. The most modest requirement of the to maintain a saw is the protection against rust actually. The saw in the forest are open to the influence of moisture and weather also. The rust color does not disappear during use, but the depressions remaining. These causes great friction and require a bigger effort. This is the maintenance practice of saw. Its tooth should be sharpened regularly before working or even after or during maintenance period also. So these will definitely increase the output from these type of saws. Then we have next power saw, or these are mechanized or be worked by using additional or supplementary power. It could be generated through generator or through battery systems, power battery systems. As a part of mechanization, power saws have been developed. And there are many kind of these saws. They are either power saw of chain, circular and drag types. Then they are used mainly for felling and cross cutting. These power chain saws are generally used by one man and to be operated by electric or pneumatic power system. In the European countries, these are being used extensively for this purpose. However, in India also nowadays these are being extensively used, and availability of labor sometime very tough job in the forestry works, or it will all obviously reduce the demand of labor. In India, power saws are beginnings to make their appearance. With the use of these saw, production has increased as much 2 or 4 times because it saves the time also. Power is generally supplied by small gasoline engine attached to the machine. Most of the saws are carried out from tree to tree by hand, but some type are operated from wheels. For especially those are for larger trees. These machines can be started by hand. The engine in most cases is double cycle, air cooled with different horsepowers using gasoline. One man power saws are chainsaws type and vary in the horsepower from 11 to 4. The length of the standard blades are from 50 to 80 centimeter in these type of saws. Here are some advantages of the power saws. It can be used or it can be operated at very ground level to cut the tree, and it will simultaneously save the main important timber portion at the butt end of trees. Then greater volume production per unit time than in the normal labor or manual labor system. These are very lightweighted or easy for transportation and portability. The machines are durable and that stand up the vigorous and strenuous operations also. There is chance of less breakage and shattering of pole in felling, because this is not worked like that axe or any other thing. So these are quite perfection in their work, the greater precision and therefore less the loss of wood in the log length. All the wearing part of the saws quickly and easily replaceable. It's good to be like this. Saws readily repaired also, and these can be replaced and sharpened easily. These can be used for horizontally and vertically both type of the workings. Then we have some disadvantages also, and the power saws have these are rugged and quite difficult to use in rugged and precipitous terrains, dense undergrowth and difficult ground cover, including windfall sometime make and it exceedingly slow and expensive to move the power saw from tree to tree. Second disadvantage, that is the labor is not generally accustomed to their use or adjustment and repair also. The saws require constant attention, replacement of the parts and sharpening. However, in the remote localities, repairs and parts cannot be readily secured. The fellers are generally not good mechanics themselves also. Here are some more tools and implements. Those are used importantly for various purposes and categorized under miscellaneous tools. So one of them is metal vases. These vases are used for during the felling of trees and to prevent the jamming of the saw in the cross cutting, and for longitudinal splitting also. So there are various type of vases. Metal vases are made of steel or iron and are generally up to 30 cm long, 8 cm width, and weigh up to 54 grams. The felling vases have a much sharper angle also. So if your metal vases are not available with you or sometime lost during that traveling or during operation also in forest, then you can sometime use wooden vases also, sometime stone vases also. So these are the vases, different kind of vases, those are used during felling operations. Next we have cant hook, or this is cant hook actually, or this is used as lever during rolling, stopping and turning the logs practices. Then we have picaroons. These are short poles around 85 to 100 centimeter length with a recurved hook like this for drying or pulling the small logs. Then we have a debarking spade which is used to remove the bark also from the felled logs. And then we have measuring stick. The measuring stick is used for measuring the log length, which has the marking ends on itself. Then we have log hook. Log hooks are used for dragging, lifting and rolling the logs. Then we have stem tightener. It is used to prevent the splitting of stem at the butt end. A stem tightener is used for this purpose. It consists of 13 millimeter wire rope having a steel core. This is laid around the stem just above the felling cut and tightened with the help of lever mechanism. The wire rope is held fast with the help of a clamping device, and which consists of a guide groove. Then while tightening, the rope automatically pulls the vase inward, thus increasing the clamping effect. And then we have cable clamp, steel arms, hinges, rings for holding the levers or fastening hook. These are the parts of this cable puller, and I think this is all about the tools and implements used during logging operations. Thank you.